Hello everyone, in this chapter we will take a look at the example of rendering of a scene and we will see how the Z buffer and color buffer are filled during the rendering of different objects. We will also understand a couple of keywords that we are going to use in the shader writing in the future chapters. One of the terms is Z-write, another is cull, another is Z-test. With these three terms, we will also understand what is Z-fighting and what are the default values of a Z-buffer. So let's begin with the rendering pipeline. So this is the pipeline that we saw in the previous chapter. First, the object is loaded, then CPU and GPU communicate, and then a draw is executed. First, the vertex shader is executed, then culling happens. And then rasterization rasterizes the screen. It finds out which pixels will be drawn. It interpolates the value and send it to the fragment shader. After the fragment shader, Z-test is done. Most of the modern GPUs are capable of doing the Z-test before executing the pixel shader, and that is what Unity does. But for the sake of understanding, we will keep following this workflow. We will begin our example from the pixel shader. And what happens after we get our color alpha and the Z depth value for a particular pixel, how Z test happens, and eventually color buffer values are filled. Consider that we have a scene, and this is the Z axis of the scene, and that is where our camera is placed. And we have a couple of objects that are arranged in the Z axis. First of all, the farthest object, that is the backplane. It is an opaque backplane. After that, there is a red translucent object that is placed. Translucent object means it's not a completely see-through object. It has some opacity and it has some transparency. And then there is a blue sphere that is placed in front of this red plane. It is an opaque blue sphere. After that, there is a diagonally placed opaque plane that is intersecting the surface of a blue sphere. And after that, in front of everything, there is a pink card that is opaque in the center and it is transparent around that. In order to give some units to our example, this is where the camera is placed, so the Z distance is 0. Pink card is placed at 10 units. It's 10 units away from the camera. This sphere is placed at 20 distance. This green card begins at 25 and as it is diagonally placed, it ends at 15. Red card is at 35 distance and this is the farthest back plane which is at 45 unit distance. Consider that all these objects are in the same render queue and this is the scene hierarchy of the scene. First, there is a back plane, then there is a red plane, then there is green plane, then blue sphere, and after that, in front of everything, there is a pink plane. So this is the hierarchy of the objects in the scene, and that is how their order in the Z-axis as well. This is the screen, and I have marked the pixel numbers of the screen as well. So every row has 10 pixels and there are 8 rows in the screen. So total of 90 pixels in the screen. And as we saw in the previous example, that there is a color buffer and Z buffer for every pixel of the screen. So this is the Z buffer and this is color buffer. And for every pixel, there is a place in the color buffer and the Z buffer. And as there are 90 pixels in the screen, we will have 90 places to fill in the Z buffer and the color buffer. So now we will start thinking of how the rendering starts. Before we begin rendering any plane, there is a default value that fills the Z buffer. The range between far clipping plane of the camera and near clipping plane is divided in the range of 1 to 0. The closest is the 0 and the farthest is 1. And anything comes in between this range is given a value between 0 to 1. And that is why by default, complete ZBuffer is filled with one value. For the sake of simplicity in this example, we will multiply this range by 100. We will think that